हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम इन द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑफ एमएससी फर्स्ट ईयर फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री सीएचपी 110। हियर इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव टू सी द आइडियल सॉल्यूशंस। सी द आइडियल सॉल्यूशंस। लास्ट लेक्चर वी सी व्हाट आर आइडियल गैसेस। आइडियल गैसेस, व्हिच गैसेस वी से आइडियल गैसेस, द गैसेस व्हिच ओबे द आइडियल गैस इक्वेशन, दैट इज PV इज इक्वल टू nRT इज अ आइडियल गैस इक्वेशन। सो दोस गैसेस व्हिच ओबे दिस आइडियल गैस इक्वेशन, द गैसेस आर कॉल्ड एज आइडियल गैसेस। Similarly, there are certain interaction between the molecules, ions, atoms of the gaseous. So, gaseous atoms, ions, molecules, they having some intramolecular forces, and they must be absent according to the ideal gas kinetic molecular theory of gases. The interaction between these gaseous molecules must be absent or they must be negligible. So, this is ideal gases. There are certain other conditions are there which are given by kinetic molecular theory of gases, and that kinetic molecular theory of gases gives the ideal condition of ideality of gases. So ideal gases are there. So those which follows the kinetic molecular theory of gases, which follows the assumptions of kinetic molecular theory of gases, are called as ideal gases. Similarly, let's see the ideal solutions. Which are the conditions, the solutions to be ideal? The first condition is that activity of each constituent of the solution, the activity is indicated by symbol A, small a. So activity of each constituent is equal to mole fraction of that constituent, its mole fraction. With such condition achieved, that activity is equal to mole fraction of that particular constituent in the solution is called as ideal solution. So activity of each constituent of the solution is equal to its mole fraction, then that solution is called as ideal solutions. See here, second ideal solution, the second the condition is that there are certain interactions. Solution is made from dissolving solute into the solvent. When we dissolve solute into the solvent, there is a preparation of solution. So in this preparation, there are certain interaction between solute. Here, in this case, we have taken volatile solvent and non-volatile electrolyte as a solute. So there are certain interaction between solute. That interactions are called solute-solute interaction. These are solute-solute interaction between solute molecules. Similarly, there are solvent-solvent interaction. There are solvent-solvent interaction between solvent molecules. Similarly, when we prepare solution from solvent and solute, then there must be interaction between solute molecules and solvent molecules. So this is third type of interaction, solute-solvent interaction. So we have solute-solvent interaction. If solutions are non-ideal, then these three interactions are different. Okay, having different magnitude. But here in this case, solute-solute interaction is equal to solvent-solvent interaction, which is likewise equal to solute-solvent interaction. So all the interactions are same here, that solutions are called as ideal solution. And third condition, important law in the ideal solutions, that is Rawls law. So those solutions which follows this Rawls law are called as ideal solution. Those solutions which follows Rawls law, the solutions are called as ideal solutions. Okay, so this is the condition which indicate the ideality of solutions, ideal solutions. Okay, so for this the solutions to be ideal, most important is the Rawls law. So we have to see the Rawls law. In order to understand Rawls law, we have to take the ideal liquids. Okay, suppose we have taken here, suppose two liquids, liquid A, ideal liquid, mixed with liquid B. We have taken two liquids, liquid A mixed with liquid B. See certain terms here, such as A, it represents activity of constituent A in solution. Activity of constituent A in the solution, A, suffix A, capital A. So, A, suffix capital B represents activity of constituent B in the solution, liquid B in the solution. So, activity. See here next, PA, it is a partial pressure of constituent A in solution. When we mix these two solutions, each has its different pressure, it apply different pressure in the mixture, and that is the partial pressure. So A has its own partial pressure in the solution. Similarly, B having partial pressure PB in the solution. Partial pressure of B in the solution. Similarly, PA0, the term used here, that PA0 is vapor pressure of pure component, pure A, without mixing. When we do not mix the A and B, then the liquid A has its own partial pressure. We call vapor pressure of liquid A has its own pressure, that is vapor pressure of liquid, pure liquid A. Similarly, PB prime represents the vapor pressure of pure liquid B. Okay, and see here, NA represents mole fraction of constituent A in liquid, in mixture. In mixture, A has its own mole fraction, Na. Similarly, NB represents mole fraction of constituent B. Mole fraction of constituent B in liquid, in mixture. Okay, so these are the terms we have to use while deriving the Raoult's law. Suppose that liquid A and B, we have taken two liquids, liquid A and B, pure liquids which follows this condition of ideality. Liquid A and B when mix, now AA represents activity of A in the solution, AB represents activity of B, PA represents partial pressure of A, PB represents partial pressure of B, PA0 represents vapor pressure of pure component A, and PB0 represents vapor pressure of pure component B. Similarly, NA represents mole fraction of A in the mixture, and NB represents mole fraction of pure component, mole fraction of B in the liquid. It is a mole fraction. Now see, from the definition of activity, what is activity? Activity, it is the ratio of partial pressure of component in a mixture, partial pressure to the vapor pressure of pure component. Okay. So similarly, here activity represents partial pressure, ratio of the partial pressure to the vapor pressure of pure component. So if we consider it for liquid A, then activity of A equal to, according to the definition of activity, activity of liquid A equal to partial pressure of A. So partial pressure of A represented by PA and vapor pressure of pure component A. So PA 0. Okay. So activity of A is represented by PA upon PA 0. Similarly, activity of B represented by partial pressure of B upon vapor pressure of pure B. vapor pressure of pure B. So this represents the activity of A, activity of B. Now look at the condition of identity. What is the condition of identity? If both constituent, if each constituent of the mixture behaves ideally or follows the condition of ideal solutions, then activity of each constituent equal to its mole fraction. Mole fraction under the condition of ideality, under the ideal condition. So under the ideal condition, under ideal condition, activity equal to its mole fraction of A represented by LA. Similarly, activity of B equal to mole fraction of B. Activity of B equal to mole fraction of B. Mole fraction of B. Now under the condition of ideality, AA equal to NA, AB equal to NB. Now, under this condition, CF will replace the A activity by mole fraction. So, mole fraction NA equal to PA upon PA 0. Similarly, mole fraction NB equal to here PB upon PB 0. PB upon PB 0. Now, if we rearrange this equation, simply we get PA equal to PA 0 into NA. NA. Similarly, PB 0 into NB. So these two equations represent the expression for Rod's law. These two equations represent expression for Rod's law. Expression for Rod's law. So Rod's law, how can we state Rod's law then? The statement of Rod's law from this equation is that it can be stated that statement of Rod's law that partial pressure of constituent in mixture, partial pressure of the constituent in the mixture is the product of vapor pressure of pure component, vapor pressure of pure component and its mole fraction in the solution. So this is the Rod's law, statement of the Rod's law, partial pressure of the constituent in a mixture or in a solution. Partial pressure of constituent in a solution is the product of vapor pressure of pure component and its mole fraction. So similarly, here partial pressure of the constituent B is the product of vapor pressure of B and its mole fraction of B. So in general, we can state that partial pressure of any constituent in a solution is the product of the vapor pressure of pure component and mole fraction of that component in the solution. So this is the statement of Rod's law. Okay. Now see that total pressure calculated. So total pressure here calculated in this way. See, total pressure P is the summation of partial pressures PH into PV. So summation of partial pressures PA and PV. But from this equation we know that PA represented by PA0 NA plus PV represented by PV0 NB. We know that summation of mole fraction is always 1, n a plus n b equal to 1. Summation of whole fractions is always unity. So from this equation we can write n a equal to 1 minus n b, n a equal to 1 minus n b. Similarly we can write here p equal to, so we have to replace this n a by 1 minus n b. So p a 0, n a should be replaced by 1 minus n b plus p b 0 n b, p b 0 n b. So we open this bracket, the p equal to p a 0 into 1 p a 0 minus p a 0 into n b plus p b 0 into n b. Okay, so common is n b n, so we can write p equal to p a 0 plus n b common here n b p b 0 minus p a 0. We obtain this equation here. So we rearrange this equation in a manner, see here p equal to same equation I am writing here, pb 0 minus pa 0 into lb plus pa 0. So we obtain this equation. Now look at this equation. This equation is similar to y is equal to mx plus c. Y is the p, on the y axis we can draw p, on the x axis here nb, whole fractions, and c is the intercept at this pb 0 minus pa 0 is the slope. So we can write c where we can plot a graph of vapor pressure on y axis and mole fractions on x axis. So mole fraction on x axis in a similar way we can write here, on this axis pa 0 increases, on this axis pb 0 increases, here na is equal to 0 initially, n a equal to 1 at the end. Similarly n b equal to 0, and here n b equal to 1, here n b equal to 0 here. Okay, so here when we plot a graph of p, vapor pressure, versus mole fraction, then this quantity represents slope, this quantity represents slope, that slope of the graph is pb 0 minus pa 0. Similarly intercept indicated by c, so intercept is given by pa 0, value of pa 0. If we plot this graph, if we increase na is 0 here, if we increase the mole fraction, the partial pressure of A, the partial pressure of A increases. Similarly, when we increase the mole fraction of B, here 0 to be increased towards 1, then we obtain these two dotted lines. In this manner. Okay. So dotted lines represents this PA. PA equal to what? It is PA 0 N A. Similarly, this line represents PB, which is equal to PB 0 into N B. Now the line, this solid line, here if we draw that solid line indicate total pressure, P, PA plus